line up the sail! Help me with this!
Adheret lumbare ad furore de hominibus quasi sterpus super rudit ascabra.
Won't be gentle if they spot me.
Thank you. strange word. Is that a word?
Lifted.
Oh, you must try my ale sometime. You must.
Eivor, you have news?
Kent's new elderman will be Thane Tedmund.
Tedmund? Oh, the Lord is testing me. He is made mouse by you Danes. Barely leaves his fortress at Rusister. How might I gain his influence if he will not speak to me? Or to anyone? It is a puzzle.
To inspire loyalty, Tedmund must owe you something. Such is his life.
Go on.
A fortress stormed. A man kidnapped. If you beat back his enemy, saved him from sure death, his gratitude would be...
Swell. It would know no bounds. But that fortress will be harder to pry open than a nun's knees.
Perhaps. Perhaps not.
Are you hiding something, Bassem?
There is a lumber mill nearby, correct?
Beamersfield. Alfred invests much in fortifying Wessex, and uses our forests to do so. The mill provides his wood.
Tedmund is there.
Impossible! How do you know?
I heard rumors that Tedmund had been lured out of self-exile to manage work on the fortifications of Canterbury.
Taking him from a lumberyard is less dangerous than assaulting a fortress, but your rescue attempt will not have the same flair. Is it worth it?
It may still work. Yes. Yes. Bring him to the megaliths.
And Fulke?
When I have Tedmund's fealty, you shall have Fulke. Now go. I will rustle up a small rescue party.
I do a roaring trade at Reculver and Tunbridge. They pay well for my catch.
The monks? Do those parchment-skinned Christians ever eat meat?
Don't you believe in Jesus? They refrain because he died for our sins.
No one will suck in the mouth of a man-headed lamb, not even God's...
Eivor, where are you?
I'm wary of this abbot, Bassem. He is self-serving and evasive. Can he really deliver Fulke?
The abbot is a friend of Fulke's. That is clear.
So long as he doesn't suspect our motive, we may have a chance.
Indeed. This brings to mind a story. Perhaps you've heard of it. The Scorpion and the Frog.
A children's story?
A cautionary tale. The Scorpion wants to cross the river, but he cannot swim. So he enlists the help of the Frog. The Frog agrees to carry him on his back, extracting a promise that the Scorpion will not sting him.
Let me guess, the Scorpion reneges, blaming his nature, and both drown.
The Scorpion crosses the river and stings an innocent man, killing him. So what does this tale tell us?
That your stories are clouded, and their meaning doubly so?
It shows that every tale has 1,000 possible outcomes, many of which are surprising. If the abbot does not deliver Fulke, you will die at my hand. And we will continue our search.
A sobering approach.
The
Themyscira is just ahead. Lead. I will follow.
I hope this chick...
With me! Watch for my lead!
This chase will catch us a plump hen.
Once the abbot has Tedmund's gratitude, he will deliver Fulke. It will cost us nothing more than this.
So
keeps
his word.
Ah, you prefer to work in the shadows.
One more time, I'm telling you, if he says my boots are dirty or my hair needs combing, I will split him open.
You're full of swamp gas. You'll do what you always do, bow and scrape to our good thane Tedmund.
I'm not even sure it's him we're working for.
Don't be daft. Who else would it be? A changeling spirited there by fairy folk. Get back.
Show me what lies ahead. This place is heavily guarded. Stop caterwauling and you'll live.
Live? Oh, saints, protect me!
Silence will save you, Tedmund. Silence, not your saints.
Flee, my friend. We have the man we came for. Does this venture not set your blood ablaze?
You don't prefer working in the shadows. And so shouldn't we be seen. Better be hooded.
And his swiftness and his escape without anyone on our heels? We hide in plain sight. Such is our way. But only until the moment of success, the final strike.
I prefer to act and speak plain. Kings and lords who do not are often misunderstood.
Yet as a leader yourself, you cannot deny that subtlety and intrigue are a cloak you must wear. How many of your clan know the true circumstances of Sigurd's absence? You see my point. A leader must know when to speak and when to stay silent. For silence is not always a lie.
It can feel like one. You truly embrace the concept of hiding in plain sight, eh? To its very fullest.
As I do.
Halt, Danes! In the name of Alfred, King of Wessex, I demand you release his royal subject into my care!
Come no closer, Christian! Else your man dies by my blade!
Please! I'm not the man you want!
Keep your eye on this one. He'll be worth a hefty bounty.
Any false moves, and I will snip your heels.
We have your man. Now let's finish this shadow play and be gone.
Are you sure that's Tedmund? He's dressed as a lord, but that man is shorter and fatter than I recall.
I'm not Tedmund. I'm not. I swear upon the holy rood, I am not Thane Tedmund.
What in heaven's name is happening here?
Who are you? Speak quickly, or I'll slit your throat and leave you for the crows.
Shergar! I'm called Shergar. Lord Tedmund pays me a measly coin to serve as his double.
Brother Shergar? You are far from Augustine's Priory.
I left the cloisters many moons ago, Your Holiness. The monastic life was not my calling.
We can use you yet, Shergar. Summon Tedmund to a meeting. Get him out in the open.
Tedmund has no care for me or what I have to say. My orders come by letter, never by mouth. I hardly know the man.
You're of no use to us then. Perhaps I should just kill you, here and now.
No, wait. Let me think. Let me think. Danes! To storm the walls, you need Danes. There's a raiding camp west of here I was told to be wary of. Acting as Tedmund, I ordered a band of soldiers to capture them. If you hurry, you may be able to stop this.
If another band of Danes wants to join our assault, we'll have the distraction we need to get inside Rucester.
If the Saxons don't slaughter them first.
I am still Tedmund to the men in the field. I could speak with their captain, send his men away.
It's a fearless plan.
The Nornir knit winding paths that cannot be unknotted. It seems Rucester was always in our path. Abbot, stay alert. We will send word when we're ready to capture Tedmund.
And this fool? He knows much of our plan.
Do what you want with him. I won't risk our plan on the shambling of this fool.
Come, Brother Shergar. And perhaps today would be the time to consider a vow of silence?
An army of Danes are all we need to take the fortress.
Let us hope. It is best to snare a wasp with honey. Have you ever considered more subtlety?
I leave manipulation to you, Bassem. You appear to see it as an art.
It is both art and science to bend a man to your will. And harder still, to convince them that they are firmly in control.
Shergar was quick to betray his lord. Do you not think he would sell us out as swiftly?
Perhaps. Perhaps not. I do not presume to know a man's heart in so brief a meeting.
His prattle was sad and ugly, like a weeping babe.
You have little patience for chittering squirrels.
And yet I allow you to squeak in my ear along all the roads and byways of Kent.
Because you are wise, and you see the same qualities in me.
That must be it. We're nearing the camp. Let us hope there are Danes enough to storm a fortress. Otherwise, this abbot's game is a long one.
It must be played, if we are to reclaim Sigurd.